first.
Sound check? Okay, okay.
Just the first verse.
Just vocals or everything?
Everything.
Okay. So we're just going up to where the coda is.
Check. Good, yep. All right. So welcome, everybody, to Worship Night. We just want to thank you guys for coming out and joining us for a wonderful evening. And we just really want to spend this evening with you guys in worship and reflection. We've got Holy Week coming up soon. And, you know, it's the time where we sort of reflect on as we walk with Jesus in his journey to the cross. So in a minute here, our swim team is going to get us started with our evening of worship. And we just want to invite you guys to just join us in let's just lift our voices up tonight and let's invite the Holy Spirit into this room, and let's just all be in the spirit of worship and gratitude as we look forward to Holy Week. So thank you again for joining us tonight, and I'm going to turn it over to our swim team.
Your rest. is you know what tomorrow brings. Not a day ahead you have not seen. So in all things be my life and breath. I want what you want, Lord, and nothing less. When you don't move the mountains, I'm needing you to move. When you don't part the waters, I wish I could walk through. When you don't give the answers, as I cry out to you, I will trust in you. I will trust in you. You are my strength and comfort. You are my steady hand. You are my firm foundation, the rock on which I stand. Your ways are always higher, your plans are always good. There's not a place where I'll go you've not already stood. When you don't move the mountains, I'm needing you to move. When you don't part the waters, I wish I could walk. When you don't give the answers, as I cry out to you,
Thank you, swim team, for getting us started this evening. So some of you, well, a lot of you probably already heard by now, but we have our swim reboot that has started not that long ago. So the group you see up here is some of the old members and a lot of new people and some returning members as well. But several of these members are completely new to this kind of setting, to playing instruments up here. Some of them take music lessons elsewhere from other teachers, but they are all learning how to lead worship, and at such young ages, and it's really wonderful to see that. So this is the future of our music at Stillwaters here, so can we just give them one more round of applause? And if you are a youth and you're not up, and you were not just up in that group, and you're thinking, you know, music is a really special thing for you, and you think this might be for you, we have an event coming this summer. It's called Jesus Music Camp, and it's on June 30th and July 1st. And what that is it's going to be a two-day thing. It's an overnighter that's optional, but youth and Stillwaters kids, it's incoming second grade and up, and they will have the opportunity to learn to lead worship, learn, you know, what is leading worship all about. They will get opportunities to experience worship. They'll get opportunities to take music lessons with myself and several others. And, you know, we'll offer lessons for drums, guitar, bass guitar, piano, voice, you know, the whole, all of it you see up here. So amazing opportunity. If you think that music is something that, you know, is really special to you, Jesus Music Camp, June 30th. We would love to see you there. I think we're all up and ready now. We're going to transition to our first group of the adult praise team. So we're going to continue with our time of worship now.
That even that which we cannot understand is in the hands hands of our great God, and there is nothing that we can do in life that can separate us from His amazing love.
Give me eyes to see more of who you are. May what I behold still my anxious heart. Take what I have known and break it all apart. 'Cause you, my God, are great.
Don't die. We do a lot of Hillsong tunes in the band. And in 2009, I remember hearing this one for the first time. And if you remember going through a big recession, everyone's scared, everyone's nervous about everything. And it was just so cool to hear this song. It was just so pure, so simple, so calming. It just seemed right. And I knew Stillwaters would love it. It's just a feeling that even when you're in that darkness, you're going to find a way out because the Lord is always there for you, leading you, guiding you, and giving you those new hopes, new dreams for a better tomorrow. The song is actually based on a verse from Isaiah 60, verse 2, and it says, "For behold, darkness will cover the earth, but the Lord will arise, and his glory will be seen upon you." The song is called "His Glory Appears."
And as we come into this song, let me share with you these scripture words. First from Peter, 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 24. "He himself bore our sins in his body on the cross, so that we might die to sins and live for righteousness. By his wounds you have been healed." And from 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 55 through 57. "Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, he gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ."
Me whole at the cross.
Okay, this last one, you got to stand up for. Got to get the blood pumping a little bit here. This is a great song, and it's a perfect song as we get closer to Easter. It's about the incredible sacrifice that our Lord made for all of us so that one day we'll have eternal life. And we're all here because of that sacrifice. We're all here because of his gift. This is Amazing Grace.
So that was the last song of this set, and now we have another set coming up. So we have a switch in the praise team and another set of different adult praise teams. So here we go. We have so many amazing musicians here. I'm going to start here as they're switching around, reading a scripture. And you might remember way back in February when we began the season of Lent. We started on Ash Wednesday, and this is a Ash Wednesday scripture, and we were talking about this evening and how we wanted to make sure that we're continuing on the journey, and so this is kind of a reminder of us humbling our hearts and opening our hearts to God. So this is Psalm 51. It says, "Have mercy on me, O God, according to your unfailing love. According to your great compassion, blot out my transgressions. Wash away all my iniquity. Cleanse me from my sin. Create in me a pure heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me." So we're going to do the next few songs. Let me just introduce the next couple songs. The first one right next is going to be a song called "I Can't Wait." And first of all, it's an acknowledgement that we come into this time. Every time we come into worship, we come with struggles and with weights and with burdens and with things that feel too heavy to bear. And so this is kind of that moment when we say, "I can't wait. I can't wait till one day when we're not bearing those burdens anymore, when we're in this heavenly kingdom and God has taken it all away and we're in this perfection." The next song after that is "Fall Afresh." And so this is a song that just invite you to just open up your heart. Allow God's Spirit to fall afresh into this space, into this room, into the rooms, anyone tuning in live stream, really opening up our hearts and letting God's Spirit fall afresh on us. So let's continue to sing in the spirit of Christ and as we worship.
That we have carried for so long, and all our burdens will be gone. I can't wait. We will find our way to an understanding of all views. No prayer shall be refused. I can't wait. Gone too far, and now I don't know where we are. I believe we will be guiding star. I can't wait. If faith is the final place where all our fears have been erased, locks are falling from the gates. We have carried for so long.
all my burdens will be gone. We will find our way to an understanding of all views. No prayer shall be refused. I can't wait.
Jo wrote this next song, Fall Afresh, and she describes her inspiration for the song as a dream that she had where she saw this rain coming down on this ancient church, and this rain was just filling the floor of the church, and it represented the presence of God. And we've been reflecting a lot on what it means to be in the presence of God, and that can look and that can feel different depending on your circumstances in life. It can look and feel different depending on just the chapter in life that you are in right now. But what we do know is that there is power where God's presence is. And so I just invite you to have an open heart and to just invite God to fall afresh on you. Make a way for your love.
Romans 8:32-39. He who did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also, along with him, graciously give us all things? Who will bring any charge against those whom God has chosen? It is God who justifies. Who then is the one who condemns? No one. Christ Jesus, who died, more than that, who has raised to life, is at the right hand of God and is also interceding for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall trouble or hardship or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger of sword? As it is written, for your sake we face death all day long. We are considered as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from me, love of God, that is in Christ Jesus our Lord.
In our scripture, we just heard all about the vastness of God's love for us. This next song is all about proclaiming the truth of God's heart and love in our lives. Would you please stand as we sing, This Is Our God?
That grave, Yahweh, Yahweh, who gets the glory and praise?
as we're nearing Holy Week, it's important for us to remember that in our walk with alongside Jesus, he's called us to take up our own cross. But when we think about what that really means, it isn't this glorious thing. To take up one's cross was to walk to their death. And so I want to invite you all to think tonight what things in your life might be your cross. What burdens have you been carrying? What things have you been holding on to? Maybe too long on your own. Maybe they're too heavy to carry on your own. Well, thankfully, we have a promise that Jesus has carried the weight of our crosses. So in this next song, we want to invite you to lay down your own burdens at the cross of Jesus and know that you can be free from these burdens when you invite his presence into your heart. Thank you.
Since we are set free by the suffering Jesus endured on our behalf, we can now rise above all those things that weigh us down. We can rise above pain and suffering. We are free to rise above everything that tries to take away the glory of what Jesus has done for each and every one of us. Let's proclaim this in our last, second to last song. Beneath the waters, I will rise. Salvation through repentance.
kind of prepare our hearts for the closing song, I thought we'd just have a time of prayer, and let's just bring our hearts to God. God, as we have just felt your presence here this evening, as we've given our burdens to you, as we've asked to have a clean heart, a pure heart again, as we seek to turn things around, knowing that we need your help. And then we look with this amazing hope, knowing that we'll rise with you. And we were reminded that there is nothing, nothing that can separate any one of us from your love in Christ Jesus our Lord. So God, continue to move in us, continue to surround us, continue to guide us. And as we continue our journey with Jesus to the cross and the resurrection, may we walk with him. May we walk with you. And even as we, on this worship night, think about all the stars, think about your great hand that created it all. On one hand, we seem to be so small, and yet you look at each one of us, created in your image, with all of the love of creation. Thank you. We love you and we praise you. In Christ's name.